Here they are.
Mr. President, what do you hope to achieve with your talks with the chairman?
I think this is very successful. Great relationship. I think we're going to be very successful. We look forward to it. We hope to it.
Have you walked back at all when you do the invasion in North Korea?
No. Thank you all very much. Thank you.
Mr. President, are you going to declare an end to the Korean War, sir?
We'll see. We'll be soon. Thank you. Thank you all very much for coming back here.
Here we go.
There you have it. You saw the president and Kim Jong Un meeting for the first time, and you saw some of that sort of signature warmth that the president has touted in his relationship with Kim Jong Un. You saw them greet each other sort of formally, shake their hands, smile, and then it looked like Kim Jong Un cracked a joke that President Trump then laughed at and responded to. We want to bring in now former director of national intelligence, James Clapper, who has been watching this along with us. Director Clapper, tell us the significance of what you've just seen.
Well, it's significant, but it's hard to separate this from, you know, the juxtaposition of what's going on here in this town, or what will transpire a little later this morning, Washington time. And I do, as others have alluded, I do worry about the president attempting to counter-distract by some big concession to Kim Jong-un. For example, agreeing to withdraw troops from the peninsula in the kind of the same spirit of the kind of gratuitous giving up the joint exercises in Singapore.
It was striking to me. Jim Sciutto was also part of this conversation. Obviously, Jim, you were in Singapore as well when the president met with Kim Jong-un. It's striking to see the president of the United States with the North Korean dictator not just shaking hands, but patting him on the back, exchanging smiles there. In a way, at this moment, and I'm talking about 6:31 a.m. Eastern time, hours before Michael Cohen is about to testify in public, Kim Jong-un may be the best friend and best ally that President Trump has right now. They were expressing this moment of warmth there. It was an island of presidential stability, you know, in a sea of problems that he's facing at this very moment.
Yeah, there's a certain
irony.
It is,
you know, and what the president's...
Jim Sciutto, go ahead.
I'll always defer to Director Clapper, but the only point I was going to make was that the president's advisors have made the point repeatedly in the days leading up to this that Mr. Trump, President Trump, is the first to try this strategy with North Korea of building a personal relationship with the North Korean leader and coupling that with punishing economic sanctions. And that's true. They're now meeting face-to-face for the second time. The sanctions regime, although U.S. sanctions on North Korea, international sanctions, not new, certainly. They go back to previous administrations.
Jim, hold on. We just want to tell our viewers that these are new live pictures. This is happening at this moment. This is their first sit-down. They seem to be taking questions.
I truly believe that this successful and great meeting that we are having today is such a courageous decision, political decision that our president is referring to.
261일 동안 그 사이 본 사망의 그 불신과 어해 있는 저희들도 있고 그 대표적인 낡은 관행 우리 길을 막 우리가 가는 길을 막으려고 했지만 우리는 그것들을 다 해결하고 극복하고 해서.
So during that 261 days since we last met, there have been some misunderstandings. There have been all these bias from the world who are misunderstanding our situation. But, and there was an hostility that still remained from the very, very past period, that from the outside. But however, we have been able to overcome all those obstacles. And here we are today, after 261 days. I truly believe that those 261 days were the days which were, and during which a lot
of days filled with a lot of thinking, a lot of effort, and a lot of patience.
But here we are today,
and I hope that we can provide an outcome that is welcomed by everyone, and I'm sure that we can do this.
Well, I wanted to say it's an honor to be with Chairman Kim. It's an honor to be together. In really a country, Vietnam, where they've really rolled out the red carpet, and they're very honored to have us. And it's great to be with you. We had a very successful first summit. I felt it was very successful. And some people would like to see it go quicker. I'm satisfied, you're satisfied. We want to be happy with what we're doing. But I thought the first summit was a great success, and I think this one hopefully will be equal or greater than the first. And we made a lot of progress, and I think the biggest progress was our relationship is really a good one. And as I've said many times, and I say it to the press, I say it to anybody that wants to listen, I think that your country has tremendous economic potential, unbelievable, unlimited. And I think that you will have a tremendous future with your country, a great leader. And I look forward to watching it happen and helping it to happen. And we will help it to happen.
우리 그 여러 번 제가 얘기를 했고 또 언론들한테도 제가 여러 번 했습니다만 저는 조선이 엄청난 경제적인 잠재력을 가지고 있다라고 그렇게 생각합니다. 그리고 앞으로 큰 성공을 이룰 거로 생각합니다. 위대한 지도자 밑에서 아주 잘할 거로 생각합니다. 그리고 앞으로 그러한 성공을 저는 계속 보게 되기를 기대하고 있습니다.
Thank you all very much. We appreciate it. And we're going to go have dinner. And then we have some big meeting scheduled for tomorrow. And we'll see you, I guess, at a news conference at some point during the day. Thank you very much.
Mr. President, you're getting Dashman Michael Cohen of his testimony.
Thank you, Dr. Dave. Thank you, Dr.
All right, President Trump with the North Korean dictator Kim Jong Un. We did hear from both leaders. Kim says, "Here we are." He says, "I hope we can provide an outcome that is welcome by everyone." And President Trump said, "I think we will have a successful meeting." He says that perhaps some of the progress has been a little slower than some wanted, but he says the biggest progress is our relationship. And by that, he means his personal relationship with Kim Jong-un, of whom he said, "I think he will be a great leader and have great success."
I'm also struck, as you know, I like body language. I'm also struck by the optics of this, how deferential President Trump looks towards Kim Jong-un. He pivots his chair towards him. He smiles. He nods while he's talking, much like I do to you. He smiles and nods while he's talking, something that Kim Jong-un didn't return, didn't reciprocate until the very end, where he said something complimentary about Kim Jong-un, who then smiled and nodded.
I don't think Kim, by the way, knows how to deal with reporters in the room. This is probably just the second time in his life he's ever been in a room at all with a free press, and I'm not sure he knows who to look at right there. James Clapper, and one final note, the president was thrown a question about Michael Cohen, did not answer the question that was thrown about the Cohen testimony. Director Clapper, what did you see in that brief moment?
Well, with respect to the question, I could bet my paycheck that that dinner will be over in time for the testimony, and the president be well ensconced in his room with a TV on. And I'm not surprised he didn't answer the question. One thing I think might be worth pointing out is the promise of rapid economic progress in North Korea is in contrast to Vietnam. Well, that's a good point. Vietnam is a former enemy and now it is thriving, but let me tell you, the two economies are vastly different, and the infrastructure in North Korea has got a long way to go to be anywhere near Vietnam, in my view.
Yeah. Jim Sciutto, tell us what jumps out at you.
Well, it's interesting for the president to draw attention to really the only takeaway from their first summit, which is that they have a relationship, right? Because remember, the administration's own standards for success in these negotiations is complete, verifiable, irreversible denuclearization. There's been no progress on that goal since that summit. That's something the president is conscious of. So perhaps highlighting what he can say is that we're talking. Now, the question is, you'll have talked twice. What will the president take away from this meeting that gets closer to that goal of complete, verifiable, irreversible denuclearization? That is a major question here.